Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I wanted to come quickly and just talk to you briefly about the difference between juice and smoothies, because I have had quite a few people confuse the two. And I have had a lot of people think that using like a blender is actually juicing, and it is not. It's not juicing. And using a blender to blend your fruits and vegetables and leafy greens is a good thing. You want to, those are called smoothies. You want to do that. That's going to help to heal your body, help your body get lots of nutrients. There's lots of fiber in that. It's going to move through your body and give you the necessary things that you need for your healthy lifestyle. But there's also a thing called juicing, where you remove the pulp from the liquid and it is a juice consistency. Like there's no fiber in, no big pieces of fiber in the juice. So what I have here is a glass of green juice that I made this morning for myself and my husband. I make about 64 ounces of juice each day. Most days, not every day, but I try to every day. And I drink a liter and my husband drinks a liter. And this is actual liquid juice. This is not, it has no pulp in it. I actually strained the excess pulp out, but I use a juicer, which extracts the pulp from the liquid. And sometimes I even pour it through a strainer to get even the little fragments of fiber out. And the reason that I like to juice is because when I juice, I get all the nutrients, they go straight to my bloodstream and my body does not have to do any work. And if you are struggling from any type of women's health issue, such as fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, ovarian cysts, heavy bleeding, infertility, any of those things, juicing is going to work wonders in your life. As a matter of fact, I wrote a women's health juicing ebook. It's called Juicing for Women's Health. If you're interested in taking a look at it, there is a link down in the description below this video where you can click and purchase my juicing ebook if you want to have access to a lot of the recipes that I use, and they're all compliant for women's health. Also, there is lots of recipes on my YouTube channel that are free, that you can get juicing recipes. Also, you can go to my website at whatchelseaeats.com and go under the recipe section, and there are some juice recipes there as well. So I happen to believe that juicing, because your body doesn't have to work to get the nutrients out, is the best option between juicing and making smoothies for healing naturally. Now, on the other hand, smoothies are going to be good as well. So for example, you don't have a juicer and you want to get nutrients in your body quickly, we'll use your blender. Your blender is grinding up all of the vegetables and fruit that you're putting in the blender, and you're pouring it in a glass and you're drinking it down, and it's making it easier for your body to break down because the blender has done some of the chewing. So it's partially sort of digested, like some of the digestion you would do with your teeth is what the blender does. As a matter of fact, the blender does a much better job than your teeth ever could, because you can't typically chew your food that long to put it in that mush consistency so that you can get it into your body. So smoothies and juices are both good, but you're going to get more bang for your buck if you're actually making a glass of juice versus a glass of smoothie. But if you only have one option, and that's a smoothie, please drink the smoothie because it is going to help you as well. And there are two things that I use. I use my juicer, I use a Try Best juicer. it's a green, it's called the Green Star. And the reason I love it is because it makes very high quality juice. I can keep it in my refrigerator 3 to 4 days, and it is, the juice is top notch coming out of that juicer. I could have chosen a cheap juicer or a cheaper juicer, but I wanted, when I bought it, I was really sick and I needed to preserve as many nutrients as I could. So that's why I ended up buying the Tribe Best Green Star juicer. And it is fabulous. And it's one of those things that unless I absolutely want to, I will never have to replace it. I also have a Champion juicer that I used for years. And it's not as good as the Green Star, but it's like, it still works. I like, if something happened to my Green Star or if I was traveling and wanted to take my Champion, I could. But it, like, when I put money into these juicers, I put money into them hoping that I'm going to be able to make them last forever. So that's my juicing story. So if you want access to the link where I bought my juicer, the exact juicer I have, I'll put a link below in the description box. The next thing is your blender. You want to buy a good quality blender, because if you're blending all the time, which I not only juice every day, but I use my blender every day in some way, shape, or form, whether I'm making a smoothie and making a salad dressing, making a soup or something, I'm using my blender every day. The blender that I chose was a Vitamix blender because I needed something that was going to last. Before I bought my Vitamix blender, I was burning out juicers left and right. It was like $80 here, $60 here, $50 here, depending on which blender I would buy. And I was like, you know what? I'm wasting all this money. I might as well spend the $500 that it takes to buy the Vitamix. And although these days you can get a Vitamix much cheaper than that, but at the time when I bought my Vitamix, which was 12 years ago, no, 9 years ago, my blender was $500 and it was the Vitamix 5200. And I love the thing. I use it every day. My husband uses it. It does all kinds of different things. I wouldn't trade it for the world. Now I know that those are expensive pieces of equipment, but those are my main cooking items. That's what I use every day, and they don't burn out. I'm not having any problems with them. Like, they're fabulous. So if you're going to drink juices and smoothies, if you can, invest in something good. If you cannot invest in a good high quality juicer or blender, what I would do is save my money. So if I had $50 towards a blender, I would see if I could find something at the store that was cheap, and I would take the money and put it aside every time I got paid so I could save up for my blender or my juicer. That's what I would do. So juice is liquid without the pulp. Smoothie is a blend, is blended in the blender, and it has all of the fiber intact. It's just smooth. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this video has helped you understand the difference between a smoothie and the juice. And the reason I don't have a smoothie here is because I didn't make a smoothie yet today, and I just wanted to make sure that I explained the difference. But if you have any other questions about the difference between a juice and a smoothie, please let me know that as well. All right, y'all. Thanks so much, and I'll talk to you soon. Take care.